shut down Ogden Avenue, basically from Sacramento to Damon, Damon to Harrison, Harrison back towards Levitt, and all around the County Medical Examiner's office. So that being the case, there are several ladder trucks that have their ladders raised. The officers now have been released from around the ambulance. The fallen officer has been placed in the ambulance on the stretcher, and officers will now file out and go back to their squad cars, and we will watch as that commences here. The ambulance is not going to be going anywhere until everybody is gets back into their cars. Everybody has been briefed. They had a face-to-face with the officers that are in charge of this ceremony and in charge of this procession. Everyone is filtering back out to reclaim their spot in their individual squad. All these cars running with the lights on, and they will be escorting the ambulance up Ogden to Damon, and then Damon north to Harrison, then a left back westbound toward the medical examiner's office, and those roads are all blocked at this time. So again, this is one of those amazing views that you hope to never see, that the men and women of the Chicago Police Department coming out in force to render honors to a fallen fellow officer who passed in the line of duty earlier this afternoon at the hands of apparently a young man who was involved in a domestic dispute and was armed with some semblance of a handgun, and shots were fired, and both the individual who was at the epicenter of the domestic violence dispute and the officer were both shot. And unfortunately, the wounds were too grievous for the officer to survive after being taken for advanced care to Mount Sinai Hospital. So now it is the procession, a solemn procession, a slow procession. Ambulance 8, Chicago Fire Department, that raced from the scene in the 5 o'clock hour this afternoon, an incident that started about 4:45 in the 5200 block of South Spaulding in Gage Park. That ambulance, once the officer was placed in the back and was being tended to by medics, raced under escort to Mount Sinai Hospital, where that officer passed of his injuries, gunshot wound to the head, to the leg. The police superintendent had indicated that he was shot multiple times, so there could have been other wounds. But what we are seeing here outside of Mount Sinai Hospital is a tremendous, tremendous show of support for this officer, his family, his friends, the city of Chicago. This is more than just mere parking cars with lights on and officers standing and rendering honors with the hand salute. This is the beginning of a process. This is the beginning of healing, even in this very early traumatic time. The healing begins immediately when you show support for your fellow man, for your fellow officer, for your fellow public servant, someone who signed up for this, someone who gave his life in the line of duty after 5 years on the police force, assigned to the 8th District, came into a call earlier this afternoon on a beautiful, sunny March day, the very first day of March. And here we are now at the emergency department at Mount Sinai with dozens and dozens, and dare I say hundreds, of officers on scene here to support the family, thinking quietly to themselves, I'm doing this job for the good of the citizens of this great, great city. And there, but for the grace of God, go I. That could be me in that ambulance. I know it, my family knows it, my friends know it, and now the citizens of Chicago. Chicago Miller, that things go wrong. Things don't go as planned. You can train for things. You can try and mitigate the problems, the issues. You can try and mitigate the risk. But sometimes, it's just not enough. And that is what all of these brave men and women who wear the badge, who wear the blue, whether you go to work as a police officer, a firefighter, a medic, anyone who works in public service, you're taking a risk when you go out there. And you're doing that for us. And that is something which is noble, that is something which is selfless, and that is something which is as honorable as one can be. To give your life in the service of your fellow man, there can be no greater sacrifice. And as we move the police vehicles into position now, and everyone, you can see a battalion chief's buggy from the Chicago Fire Department. They've been here because they're coordinating the salute along the route, getting the ladder trucks in place, the engine companies in place, to show their brothers and sisters that we're all one big family, caring for the citizens of Chicago and caring for one another. Because the caring and the helping starts at arm's length. You look at your fellow officer and you say, you know what, brother or sister? We're in this together. And we're going to be in it from the beginning to the end. And you will never be alone. You will never walk alone. And should the ultimate sacrifice occur and you lose your life in the line of duty, brother, I'll be here for you. We got officers coming down, some coming down Sacramento, a lot of them going down Ogden, some going down Roosevelt. Widen out to show all of the squads here, all the way over, widen all the way out. Thank you. Push back into the hospital. Show the hospital. Yeah, get in. Yeah, this is good. If you could kind of hang out right here.